Let's go back to the designer once again to remember what we're doing. We are going to display a new image every 5 seconds in the image component. And while that image is showing, the user has to press one of the three buttons, and they can gain a score if they get it if they get the right button. So for instance, cardboard box needs to be recycled, so you'd hit the recycle button. If they press the wrong button, they'll lose a point. What we need to do now is to figure out how we're going to set the image to change every 5 seconds. So let's start with the image. So if we go over here, we call that object. And looking through these green blocks, there is a set object picture 2. Now we need to set it to the name of one of our files. So let's say we want to set it to Apple PNG. To do that, we need to grab a text block. We'll grab a blank one and type that in exactly as it's spelled. So apple.png. Now we've got the block to set it. Now where do we put it? A block just sitting out here on its own will never get executed until it gets put into an event block. So everything that happens within an app only happens when an event, like someone clicking a button, gets triggered. However, we don't want to set it when someone clicks the button, do we? So when do we want to set the picture? Well, we need to set the picture when the app first starts, every 5 seconds, so that will be when the clock timer goes off. We want to put up a new picture. And then also when the user does click a button, and we're going to decide whether they click the right button and increase or decrease their score, but also put up a new picture. So we're going to have to do this in a few places within our app. Let's start with screen one and this screen one initialize. This event happens when the app starts. So when screen one opens, we can do certain things. For instance, by setting the object's picture to a particular image. Now we can test this out by starting up the emulator. But we need to start thinking of a way to change up the picture so it's not just Apple. So we've got the Apple. Now a nice neat trick is if we go to connect, we can say refresh companion screen, and it refreshes it again, the Apple. We don't want the Apple every time. We want to change it.